through me. I am a woman, and I deserve all the attention of me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
They say it's better to have loved and lost than to have never loved at all. And some may say what I've experienced isn't truly love. No, not at all. But if my experiences are counted, and this is the aftermath of having lost love, then maybe perhaps they had it all wrong. Maybe no experience of love is the best thing of all. If I've never experienced love, then I'm only left with the fantasy of what it is and how it feels and what it looks like. I can view love as this beautiful thing that expels people through time and space, where butterflies roam free in the stomachs of those pierced with the love-filled arrow of Cupid's embrace. No experience means the purity of no expectations, the ability to get caught in a moment of now in the timeless space of love. How beautiful love could be without the experiences that haunt me, the same experiences that taught me that love was many things, that the loss of love is the only thing that love truly guarantees. It's not meant to be smothered, held onto, or even owned. That love is much like the butterfly, only feeling free when it can fly. Roam from flower to flower, producing smiles a million by the hour. If you ask me, I would say that experiencing no love at all is the beauty that comes from experiencing love in it all. Fuck love. That's been my shit since I was 15.
Rewind!
Fuck love. That's been my shit since I was 15. Now I'm 30, still singing the same song. Which makes me wonder, is it love that's the problem? Or the ones I choose to experience love through? All the cheating, toxic communication, uncontrolled anger, insecurity, that's all on me and my choice in men. Which further reflects on my feelings about me. Do I dislike myself that much to feel that me alone would never be enough? To silence myself and walk on pins and needles just to avoid an outburst? Surely this can't be love. But then again, if I look at my parents and grandparents and their parents, this is exactly what love looked like. The only difference was they stayed together through it all and acted blind to the bullshit. So maybe it is fuck love. Or maybe just fuck the love that we've taught ourselves. Fuck the love that has been shown to us from our elders. Fuck the love that society says is real. Fuck the love that fairy tales pierce within your mind. And fuck the love that makes you feel like you are incomplete without another there to make you whole. Yep, that's my saying and I'm sticking to it. Until society learns to reflect the love shown by God, nature, and the universe, fuck love, fuck love, fuck love. And fuck this society for ruining the meaning of love.
Give it up one more time for Mark Dice, Sasha, and Fuck Love. Fuck Love. Fuck William Chicken.
Fuck William Chicken.
But not give me my roll when I order my fries. Fuck Popeye's Chicken when I order a three-piece not giving me my pies. Fuck Rudy's, fuck Luby's, fuck 7-Eleven too, and fuck Wendy's, fuck IHOP, and the Waffle House too. Fuck Henderson Chicken, fuck T's, and Reckless Barbecue, and if you need all my spots, fuck you too. I'll just freestyle, I'm sorry. Alright, are y'all okay with one more intermission?
Yeah!
Y'all okay with that?
Yeah.
Then we get some more portion, get y'all home, is that okay?
Yeah!
Alright, if anybody just came in, welcome to the release session. I'm your host, I am Will. This is my DJ, Southside Finest Uncle Jay. We are the release session. Welcome to Bistro 808. Hope you got your food.
No.
Look, my apologies.
It's coming. It's coming. All right. She's like, yeah, you got me fucked up. It's coming. All right, Jay, throw some on for me, because these hungry ladies beat me up. Throw some on. Hurry up. Throw some on.
Yeah.
I love you, believe all of the things she will change.
All right, turn that shit off.
You remind me of a girl that I once knew. See her face whenever I look at you.
You really think about that lyric. You remind me of a girl I once knew. See her face every time I look at you. Okay, so you're trying to say that your new girl is like your old girl?
Everyone got a type, fam.
That's true.
The older you get, they change.
That's true. And most types be walking by while she's saying, I'm waiting on my type. And your type just walk the fuck by. Hey, real quick, on some serious shit. I wanted to see if you would take 30 seconds, a moment of silence, to 19 children that were hurt, injured. Some lost their life. We all, most of us have kids, those who don't. Let's show some respect to the parents and families of those individuals. 30 seconds of silence, please. Yes, yes. Let's keep those families in our prayers, man. That's hard. That's hard. That's hard to take your kid to school that morning, and that's the last time you see them. That's hard. And I can relate. I've been there. I can relate. All right, we down here. So I've been begging all night. I bought 8 banana puddings. I gave her $20. I let her use my car, and she said she would do poetry because I did all that. I mean, I know it's an 85 colors, but it runs, okay? All right. I mean, all you get to start it, take a pen and put it in the glove compartment and pull the seat back, and that starts the car. Okay, you're good. Just bring it back because my aunt needs to go to work. All right, so I got on the mic. We're gonna bring her up here and let her do a goddamn thing. Is that cool?
Yay.
And then we down here. Yeah. Bring it up to the mic. Bananum, my friend, great person, great poet, does a hell of a massage. That's her other professional business. Y'all need to check her out. So Clinique. She got these names with it. Y'all be shitting it. So Clinique, professional masseuse. She is super dope with it. And I've been doing so long, and I appreciate it all the time, because she always shows love. So, give it up for the one and only.
Hold on.
No, your poet name. Asymmetry! Show us some love, y'all. She's doing us a great favor. Show us some love.
How you fuck up all the names? All of them. First off, thank you guys for supporting Bananum Pudding. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I have 7 left. I hope not to walk out the house out this building with them, but they won't make it home. They never make it home. Hope you guys enjoyed your evening. I guess I'm gonna be the closeout tonight. So thank you guys for staying. All right, so I'm gonna do one, maybe 2 poems. This one is called I Am Enough. I am enough. Pretty, fine, woman, enough. Smart, strong, sophisticated, enough. Girl, dame, madam, lady, female, her, she, miss, ma'am, I am enough. There is power in this gender, like leprechaun gold and unicorn horns, like black fists adorning blue skies in blood red Minnesota, making purple rain, pumping air back into deflating lungs, or serving street justice to George Floyd type murderers. I am woman, hear me roar. I am enough for doing too much, for being too loud, for acting too ghetto, black woman, proud, black girl, magic, female first. I am her. She is me. They are we. Is us. Is one. I took my time to write this poem because someone needs to know she is enough. Soft, lovable, feminine, enough. Bold, courageous, tough, enough. Reconstituting girl power from dehydrated scrotums like raisins back into grapes, like humans back into apes, like Jesus back into God, back into me. Take me back to me, back to chivalry, back to holding doors because it makes me feel seen, not overlooked. Not overwhelmed by stereotypes I've never spoken, making me feel broken and never enough in anyone's eyes but mine. Making me question my own existence to the point of wanting to trade all of this organic goodness for some GMO bullshit. I am enough, worthy, deserving, capable enough, caring, sensual, wifey enough. Like rainy days and sunsets, like shooting stars and solar eclipses, I am a natural occurrence, undeniable. I am a force to be reckoned with, undisputable. And I'm reclaiming my identity by condemning the denigrating words placed on those of us that incubate and birth every human being on this planet Earth for the sake of saving ourselves, for the sake of preserving our mental health, for the sake of everyone who calls us mom, mommy, mama, mother, ma, sister, niece, daughter, auntie, because we can't expect to be saved by anyone else. No love is greater than that that you have for yourself. It's time to fill up those big girl panties and strut. No filter, no fear, no fucks. Enough is enough, and so am I. Hemmed up. Ladies, have you ever been hemmed up? I mean, one hand cradling the back of your head, the other so reassuringly around your waist, it feels like training wheels and a helmet. Like, really hemmed up? His body supporting yours, supporting the building as if it would crumble till you let go while he siphons kisses from your face like they're the sweetest thing he's tasted since mother's milk. Hemmed up like Sunday mornings down in the Delta. Like long pant legs being sewn by grandmama's hands. No spoken words, but everything about it is poetic. Hearts race like wild Mustangs playing patty cake through our chests. Nipples livin' like 4 o'clock at the sight of the morning sun. He had me hemmed up and it was beautiful. A scene of erotica playing out for the world to see, taking turns sucking lips as he readjusts himself, readjusting me. Pressure bust pipes, and I could tell he wanted his pipes to bust on me. And he had me hemmed up, held up, unable to escape his grasp, his hand now cradling my ass, and I became lost in the moment, forgetting the most important thing. Breath, hot and heavy, untangling ourselves, watching his fine ass as he walks away. Then he turns back to retrieve his heart he had lain at my feet, only to find my foot on it, because it was being hemmed up by someone other than me. Thank you. Yeah. I'd like to say thank you, Will, for putting on this beautiful show tonight, the relief session. Again, thank you for supporting Phenomena Pudding. Sign up for my email list because this is just the beginning. I'm just gonna tell you, this is just the beginning. I do have vegan pudding. I have more flavors.
Rewind.
I have vegan pudding. I started excited over here. Yes, vegan pudding. Strawberry banana pudding is only the beginning. So sign up for my email list. I do have 7 puddings left. If you want to come buy me out, please buy me out. Thank you guys for coming. I hope you enjoyed your evening. And I'll turn it over back to Will.
Okay, I got a question. I'm sorry, babe, I've been drinking today. But if you're a vegan, you don't eat meat, right? Right? So, how do you have vegan banana pudding if there's no meat to come with? So why call it vegan then? Why not say it's banana pudding?
No dairy.
Oh, so that's the meat?
No, animal products at all.
No animal products? Yeah. So the milk from the cow, the meat?
No milk.
Okay, I didn't get it. I didn't get it. I mean, I'm sorry.
No duck food.
Okay, well, she told me she was vegan. And I told her, you still eat meat tonight. She told me she was vegan. I said, you still eat meat tonight.
That was good.
All right, I'm going to do one more piece and we'll take this thing down home. Is that okay? See if we can get a little serious. The name of this piece is called You Choose. The risk of fanatic, a highway in the attic, looking through stacks of boxes, picks of toxins and Xanax in the boxing. I've never been a fan of Poppins unless it's Mary. Quite contrary, lots of two, but I never met a fairy. I prefer goodbyes. It ride past talking sick, twisted toxins and boxed him, forgetting who the boss is. If he's using, I'm sorry. You protect me, but you are me, or at least you are inside of me. You're somebody that somebody would give an eye to be. You're my saving grace when the devil lies to me. Bribery in the library, old book of the lies they carry. They don't carry the weight. The Holy Spirit catches me when I faint, but I've never been fake. Stop playing with me, thoughts for God's sake. I got God's son tatted on my arm, so don't make me get it tatted on my face. I never been flattered when I'm praised. That's just not how I was raised. I came up different. The room gets quiet when I Am Will is mentioned. He's the best. He's the worst. Is he a blessing? He's a curse. He's a little crazy, or he's just a little bit tad bit crazy. I just can't wait till they finally agree or say maybe. Social media made me. Social media praised me. Social media paid me. People like social media raised me, which means I raised some of them. I was their escape when classmates made fun of them. And that's why they listen like they do. They'd rather listen to me than hear from you, because I don't judge them or make them choose. And they don't judge me when I want to let loose. So whatever inside to me gets inside of you. I've never been lied to, and you never been lied to. The devil turns the switch off, but I light up the room. And if the oxymoron, the squirm, devil squirm, is not enough, I just want the devil to burn. You ruined my life, but this time it's my time to squirm. So squirm, you sick little worm. I decided to call my life the release session because it sells. I got a picture of my son that just sits on the shelf, and I feel as it shifts in my health. The devil come lurking, I'm overwhelmed. He wants the spotlight, but I want the step. I want peace, and the world wants wealth. Well, like me and you, I can tell. I got broken ribs from Christians that kicked me when I fell. I point to people in heaven, you condemn them to hell. I'm thirsty for living water, man, where is that well? I'm not okay, I don't feel well. I got a secret for you if you promise not to tell. I'm loud in my poetry, but I live alone in the shell. I've been so close to death, I got a whiff of a smell. It's like I've been cursed by a witch with a spell. I'm struggling to stay afloat, as you can tell. I got waves of depression, it's like it's swept in the well. I'm imprisoned by paranoia and I'm locked in a cell. But I'd rather live in heaven than die in hell. Yes, y'all good? Did you enjoy yourself?
Yes!
Will you come back?
Yes!
Okay. This is show number
125.
I'm like, man, what show are you at? I'm just kidding. Show 115. My birthday show is July the 9th. My birthday is on the 8th.
We got the same birthday.
Council in the building. All right, so Jeff got to come celebrate with us. Birthday show, July the 9th. That is Saturday. Next show, come celebrate with me. Have a drink with me, have a food with me, support you, whatever you do. But come celebrate if you can. Tonight's show has been recorded, still recording. If you get a chance, go to your YouTube channel, put in The Release Session. My YouTube channel comes up. Subscribe, costs you absolutely nothing. You can see this tonight's show many other shows I did in the past. You can also see one of my music videos, a short video of my movie I just finished shooting up a few months back, all my goofy-ass TikTok videos, all my Snapchats, all me just acting stupid. All right, go to YouTube, check it out. You can also follow him on Facebook, William Shelton J.R. Jr. You can also follow him on Instagram, IamWill43 or The Release Session LLC. If you are a cigar smoker, I also represent Cigar Lifestyle, Mobile Cigar Lounge. We all over the city. You catch me at Lava Cantina on Sundays, 4:13 Wednesday through Saturday. Like, you got a lot of shit going on. Yeah, I'm gonna hit up there in a minute. But follow me, check it out, support. Shout out to the poets that came through. Shout out to my man Gino, Lady B Smooth, Christina, Ty in the building, Melvin, Sassy in the building. Thank you to all the poets that came out and spit this thing. Hey, shout out to the staff here. I know you guys had a lot going on tonight. We tried the best and we appreciate it. It's all we asked for. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, because I'm gonna need a shot in a minute. Did I leave out anything, Jay? Oh, the release session. If you have a business, you are promoting, networking, you want to say a prayer, you got something on your chest or your mind you want to get out, you have my microphone. Say whatever you like. Anybody.
Right here.
This guy
right here.
Come on up, brother. Speak your piece.
Hello, everybody. Hello. My name is Calvin. I am the traveling painter. If anybody need a painter, I'm here. 773-788-5229.
Do that one more time.
773-788-5229.
Now sing it now.
773-788-5229. Woo! Yeah. 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 I'm finna go
777-93-11-5-7-9-2, if that's all right.
777-93-11.
Please, baby, please, can I come tonight?
Hey! Hey, Uncle Jay, that has been requested. You need to put on 773-9311. That's the number of the song.
And call Calvin if you want some painting done.
777-9311.
Call Calvin if you want some painting done.
Hey! Talking about freestyling. Okay, with that being said, Jay, you playing? 777-9311.
Come on, man.
Hey, Jay, play the song I asked you to play, man, for the ladies.
We're going out on the song. We ain't leaving until you play that song.
Play the song for the ladies I told you to, Jay.
And even now the music, the patio is lit out there. Shout out to the patio. They out there smoking, drinking, you want a little air, whatever. Just have a smoke, have a drink. You ain't got to go home. Well, that's kind of saying the same thing. But yeah, but you got to go home. Anyway, we're going to smoke, drink, we're going to chill out for a little bit. You got something to say? Come on up here, guys. Come on up here.
Thank you.
So I hope y'all got that information. Although I know personally, she don't like bony dudes. She put that on her Facebook page. She don't like bony dudes, so whatever that means. She put that on Facebook page. Yeah,
she like the thick ones.
I just missed y'all.
She like a hard to kidnap. That's what I am, hard to kidnap.
Right. You know what? He said, I can't be taken.
They just not gonna push me in their van. Right. You ain't gonna just grab me. But you could probably get real.
Yeah, I was just gonna say that. Let me tell you something though. Let me tell you something. I did 30 fucking push-ups this morning. 2 bananas and a water. I'm 30 pounds heavier. And this is a numb baby all day. So when I got the all on, hold on, I'm gonna show y'all something. Watch this.
When you put that Earl on, we see.
You see how it rolls?
Yeah, that's real shit.
That's real shit.
Yeah.
Earn your shirt on this. Earn your shirt on that. All right, let me stop bullshitting. Thank y'all for coming out. Thank you everybody for supporting the staff. Shout out to Banana Eminem. Shout out to Hub. Shout out to the poet Bistro 808. Jay gonna still play some music. We ain't gotta get up out of here. We gonna jam a little bit. We gonna jam a little bit, drink a drink. You can still chill out. Ain't that type of party. Let's go wind down a little bit. You got that song? What is it? 555? You got that? 972? What's the name of it? Oh,
999.
Damn, Jay, what a song at?
1-800.
What is he up there, Texan?
I think he's the best. I'm the best. I didn't get it in English, so shit, you know.
That was good.
Okay. Turn it up.
Hey, let's go.